Sports Gaming Universe.
Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Derek Jeter final season series here, player lock series, taking the Yankee captain through his final run through a Major League Baseball season here in MLB 14, the show. So it is the continuation of the series with the Red Sox here at Yankee Stadium. Game one went down in the last episode just yesterday. Got enough footage to do another episode for you again here today. So game two of this series, both teams at a 500 record at 5-5 to start the year through 10 games, and Jeter with a 425 average early on in the season here. I don't know if that's going to hold. As a matter of fact, I wouldn't expect that to hold, but it is a pretty decent start average-wise. He also has two homers and about 8 RBI, did I say, on his ledger, but he's striking out there. Lester gets him to chase, and we're going to put the extreme shift on David Ortiz, as you would expect here. Boston up 1-0 at this point in the third inning, and it's a 1-2 count to Ortiz, who's going to actually take this right up the middle. Hey, pretty good placement there. Just had to range to his right and throw the big man out, throw Big Poppy out at first base. So it's 3-0 in the bottom of the fifth here, and Jeter's going to line that to right center. Base hit, and oh, the right fielder dives and cannot come up with it. Runner coming around third to score. Jeter in to second with an RBI double. Great job right there, getting his team on the board with a solid hit to right, and the right fielder could not cut it off. So runner scores all the way from first base. Nice effort there, but nope, gets by him, and it's going to the fence. So it's 4-1 Boston now. Yankees, that was their only offense so far. That's trailing towards the right field line, but it will hang up there long enough to be caught. So no further damage done by the Yankees there through seven innings. Here comes Jeter one more time. He's 1-for-4 with that double and RBI, but it's pretty much all the Yankees have to hang their hats on today. Let's see if Jeter can do anything in the ninth with runners at the corners. One out, but an 0-2 count, and he's got to protect the plate, and he pops out to the first baseman. Ah, was hoping for more right there. Hoping for maybe a rally, but it's not going to happen at this point, at least not off of Jeter's bat, as the best he could do was fight that off, and it is caught in foul territory behind first base. So there you go. It is a 4-1 victory for Boston. They even the series at a game apiece. John Lester gets the victory, and Daniel Nava was the one to go deep in that game. So next up, it'll be Tanaka versus Buchholz in game three of the four-game set. So what's this? Yankees and Red Sox fraternizing together before a game? Blasphemy! Come on! You guys are the enemy. I think the fans take that farther than the players do, don't you think, in real life? I've even seen athletes come out and say that. You know, it's like, I think the fans play up the rivalries, you know, most often more than the players do. Although, don't tell that to the Dodgers and the Diamondbacks. I'm sure that, you know, there's some actual hate there. Oh, that gets over the right fielder's head, and it's going to bounce off the base of the fence. We got a runner coming around to... Oh, he's not going to score. He's tagged out at the plate, robbing Jeter of an RBI. Ah. Oh, well. That was a nice play there. A nice toss to get him at the plate, so unfortunately we don't get a run there. It's 5-3 in the third. Lots of runs today. Jeter's gonna hit this one to center field. Does it have anything for carry? Nah, warning track power at best. I think right in front of the warning track actually is where he corralled that baseball, but Jeter gave it a ride. So he's 1-for-2 now on the game with that double in the first inning. Again, no RBI because the runner was cut down at the plate. But let's see what is in store for this at bat as he settles in here and looking for a pitch he can hit. It's 5-4 Boston, and it's going to dribble that to the right side. Pedroia, no, not in time. He cannot gather it and throw there. Let's see what they go ahead and score this, but I am pretty sure that's going to be an infield base hit. Pedroia didn't boot it. He just didn't quite field it cleanly. So, yeah, I think that's going to be an infield hit for Jeter. And he comes up now in the ninth. 10-6 ball game. And, had a wide open space to slap that through between first and second. And the runner will hold at third because they know they need more than just one run. They're not going to chance getting thrown out at the plate again. But Jeter takes that outside pitch and does, well, what he can do with it. Gets a base hit to right. Simple, plain and simple, but it sets his team up maybe for a comeback here. Two outs, two strikes. This pitch is clobbered to right, but it is caught by the right fielder, and that is ball game. The Red Sox win game three and are up 2-1 in the series. The Yankees will try to get a split in the next game here tomorrow, but for today, the Red Sox get to celebrate at Yankee Stadium, and it's always a good day for them when that happens. So, Middlebrooks is your star today with 2 homers and 6 RBI. My goodness. Yeah, he put the Red Sox on his back today and led them to victory. So we got Kuroda going against Felix DeBront next. Kuroda's got a 2-0 record. Got to be our best pitcher to date. Yeah, all right. So Red Sox, Yankees one more time. And this one is on Sunday Night Baseball. Oh, yeah. Going to be the show of shows tonight. You know, every time the Yankees and the Red Sox lock up on a weekend series, you're going to have Sunday Night Baseball at the end of that series. That's just kind of how things go in Major League Baseball. So here comes Jeter to the plate for his first appearance in this game. Kind of collecting his thoughts here, wrapping his bat there, hoping he's got a hit or two in there for today. Let's see how it goes in the first inning. It's going to be hit to right field. Again, slicing towards the line and fairly deep, but it'll be caught at the track once again. So, again, he cannot get it out of there. Even with the short porch, I don't know. I don't expect a lot of power out of Jeter this year, but hopefully we can hit a few out. He's already got 2 on the season. And, hopefully he can take advantage of that short porch from time to time. Here he gets frozen on an 0-2 pitch. He doesn't quite agree, but I think, if you look at the replay, I think he did nick the corner there. I know some of these home plate umpires have different strike zones and they can interpret it differently, but that one looked like it was legit, but Jeter didn't like it. So it's a 5-0 Yankees lead. However, hey, can we make that 6-0 with a base hit to center? Here comes the throw and it's cut off. Yes, sir. 6-0 Yankees. So they may just get that split in this series. That looks like it's going to be the end for Felix DeBront today, as they're going to come and get him eventually. So with a 2-2 count and 2 outs, this is going to be a base hit, getting Jeter to second. So runners at first and second, looking for even more possibly. Yeah, we'll see here. 3-2 count and the runner's off because of that count. And it is a base hit to right and he's going to score, Jeter. It's another insurance run. It's 7-0 now. This time it's Soriano with the RBI, as we'll see his swing again. He's taking the ball the opposite field there and able to get Jeter home all the way from second. So here we go. Got another at bat. 1-for-3 on the night. Like I said, hoping he's got a couple hits in this bat. It's 8-0 here with a runner on second. Oh, that's a strike, but why are we still in third with an 8-0 lead? That's not really very good baseball etiquette, but hey, it's Yankees Red Sox. Well, who cares about etiquette? And that base hit will plate the runner. So an RBI for Jeter after the man standing on third base. Easy right there, and it's now 9-0. The captain gets another hit. And like I said, there you go. 2 hits in that bat tonight. Very good. And the Yankees do indeed even the series. They get a shutout. 9-0. 3-hitter. Wow, Kuroda's on fire, man. 3-0 now. 2.25 ERA. Looking good. DeBront, not so much. So here's the game that was supposed to happen yesterday for Jackie Robinson Day.
Coming up on First Pitch here in the Bronx, it's the Cubs and the Yankees, and it's coming up next. About set for baseball now on the show as you get a look at Yankee Stadium here in the Bronx. Lots of number 42s on the field as we celebrate Jackie Robinson Day with a good matchup between the Chicago Cubs and the New York Yankees.
So in real life yesterday, this game got postponed to be played today as part of a doubleheader, I guess weather permitting. I don't know where I'm at. It's snowing right now, so I'm not sure what the forecast is like in New York, but here you see Jackie Robinson Day starting off poorly for Derek Jeter right here as he pops out to Rizzo. And it's a 1-0 Yankee lead in the third when he's up again, and this ball is going to be smacked to center, but not very deep at all. Center fielder will camp under that and make the catch. So Jeter's 0-2 to start the day. All right, well, maybe we can get it turned around here eventually. Still a 1-0 lead, 0-2 count, and was that a replay of the first at-bat? No, but same result essentially there. Pop foul to Rizzo once again, and Edwin Jackson is rolling. But hey, there's a pitcher's duel going on here. Jeter's 0-3, but there's a lot of 0-4s on this day, because look at this. It is still a 1-0 game. In the eighth, runner on first, finds a pitch, hits this past the third baseman. So a rare display of offense on this day, getting a hit. Runners at first and second now. Maybe the Yankees can push home an insurance run and assure themselves a win here today after splitting with Boston. They'd like to sweep this quick game with the Cubs, and they do get the 1-0 victory. Look at that, 1-0 shutout. Their only run coming in the second inning. So we move forward to the second and final game of this quick series with the Chicago Cubs. And like I said, this will be game two of the doubleheader today in real life, but we split them up between 2 days here in our series. So here we go to battle once again, and we are back at 500, 7-7. The Cubs, not so much. What were they, 5-8 there? So Jeter now, I think that said he's third in the league with that 407 average. So it's dipped a little bit, but he is still definitely doing well there average-wise. So first inning, a runner on first, nobody out. Oh, there you go, laying down a beautiful sack bunt. Going to throw him out at first, but he does his job getting that runner over. After a 1-0 game yesterday, they know that runs are at a premium here, so they'll go ahead and move this runner over early and try to get an early lead. Let's see if it pays off. Yes, sir. Ellsbury does come around to score, so they get the 1-0 lead. Coming up again here later on at an even 400 average. He had that sack bunt earlier, but he's still looking for his first hit of the day. We're in a 2-2 ball game in the fifth, and that is going to be to the gap in right center. Going to split the difference between the outfielders and crash up against the base of that fence. Is he going three? No, he's going to stop at second wisely, because I think they would have thrown him out on the relay there. Had he tried to go for three, but it is a extra base hit for Jeter here as he tries to get to the point where they can crack this tie. And we'll see what the batters can do behind him. Well, apparently not much because he didn't score. And as a matter of fact, the Cubs take the lead 3-2. Jeter hits this ball to right. What's the carry on this baby? Not much. It's going to be a routine flyout to right field, so nothing doing right there as the seventh inning ends. Will he get another shot at this? Yes, he will. 1-3 with that double in the fifth inning. But he needs something right here as they are down 5-3 in the ninth. He could tie it with a home run. And he gets a solid shot to center. It is going to be a base hit. Runner going to go to third? No. He's going to be careful here. You don't want to run yourself into an out in third base and be the final out and kill the rally here. So with runners on first and second, can they get the comeback? No, it falls short. So Chicago wins the game and splits the series at a game apiece with the 5-3 victory. So that's going to do it for our episode here today. Jeter working through this first month, April, of his final season. And like I said, we'll sim some and play some. And we're going to have a good time here with Jeter in the final season. Come on back next time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.